Hello friends and welcome back to my channel. Have you ever found yourself in the position where you want to use artificial intelligence tools ethically in your work, but aren't sure how? Well, as a researcher and university lecturer, I've been looking into this topic and helping social work, health and social care professionals to think critically about how they can ethically use AI to improve the services they provide to their clients. I do this by getting professionals to consider questions based on several research-based lessons around AI and ethics. In this video, I'm going to outline five of these many lessons, along with some questions to encourage you to think about how you too can begin to critically use AI ethically in your work. Now, while these five lessons I'm going to outline here have been drawn from my experiences of researching and working in the field of social work, the lessons I outline in this video should apply equally well to anyone working in any field who is thinking of using AI ethically in their work. So, let's get started. Before using AI in any area of your work, it's always important to ensure that you explain to your clients the potential benefits and risks associated with AI tools you want to use. Once you explain the benefits and risks, you should obtain your client's consent before using AI tools in your work with them. So I teach my learners that when gaining consent, it's crucial that you evaluate your client's ability to provide informed consent and respect their judgment about whether to accept or not the use of AI in your work with them. So let's think about a couple of questions here at this point. Ask yourself, do you know enough about the AI tools you want to use for you to be able to explain their benefits and risks to your clients? Now, if the answer is no, then where could you go to find out this information so that you can feel confident in gaining your client's informed consent? Another important lesson in using AI tools like ChatGPT, for example, is to consider how data collected from clients is to remain private and confidential. This is a responsibility that all workers must take seriously. To do this, you need to ensure that the AI software you use is securely encrypted and protected from any potential data breaches. When it comes to using any AI system ethically, it's really important to understand what measures are in place to prevent unauthorized access to AI-generated data. This includes preventing vendors who supply and support the AI software from accessing confidential information. The ethical use of AI should always emphasize the importance of safeguarding sensitive information to ensure that clients' privacy is always respected. It's about maintaining trust and integrity in the use of technology in our professional practices. So let me ask you another question here. How can you find out what steps are taken to safeguard client data and prevent unauthorized access when integrating AI tools into your practice? Now this one I find really interesting. When workers depend on AI to assess client situations and challenges, they need to be watchful about minimizing the chances of generating flawed assessments and intervention plans created through flawed AI datasets. This risk arises when workers rely solely on AI-generated assessments without adding their own independent assessments and professional judgments. Flawed assessments can result in inappropriate or unwanted interventions, potentially causing significant harm to clients. So it's essential for social work, health and social care workers to strike a balance between using AI tools and exercising their professional judgment to ensure accurate and beneficial outcomes for their clients. The questions to consider here are, how do you intend to minimize the risk of flawed assessments and intervention plans that may come about from relying solely on AI-generated data in your practice? What strategies will you employ to strike a balance between using AI tools and applying your professional judgment to ensure accurate and beneficial outcomes for your clients? Algorithmic bias is something that everyone using AI should be aware of because of the potential risks it brings. AI relies heavily on machine learning, which sifts through vast amounts of data to answer any questions or activities you ask AI to perform. However, this data may not accurately represent the many diverse backgrounds of our clients. This then poses a risk because the algorithms used to assess clients and develop interventions might contain significant biases related to race, ethnicity, gender, sexual orientation, gender expression, and other vulnerable or protected categories. Research has shown that algorithmic bias can show up in various ways, such as in agency recruitment, online marketing, and facial recognition tools. Machines can, unfortunately, treat similar people and objects differently. Recent research, of which I've included some examples in the section below, have uncovered troubling examples where algorithmic decision-making doesn't meet our required expectations. This means that some algorithms may end up replicating and even amplifying existing human biases, especially those affecting protected groups. This is actually quite a complex issue that demands careful consideration in the development and use of AI tools in social work, health, and social care. So I've got a couple of questions for you here. What steps can you take to find out more about AI-based algorithmic bias? How can you ensure your use of AI in your work minimizes the negative impacts of algorithmic bias? Because of the fast-paced and constantly evolving world of AI technology, best practices are changing at speed too. For professionals looking to integrate AI into their practice, there is an ethical duty to stay up to date with research-informed developments so that we can adjust our approaches accordingly. In whatever field you find yourself in, you should look for resources that can help you ensure that your practices align to your profession's ethical codes of practices. We must recognise that technology is constantly changing, and its uses in practice will be expanding in various forms. That's why social work, health and social care workers should stay informed about the latest technologies available and research best practices, risks, ethical challenges and ways to manage them. It's all about staying current and ensuring that technology enhances rather than detracts from your work processes and outcomes. So finally, let's consider these questions. How do you plan to stay updated with rapidly changing best practices in AI technology to ensure that your professional practice remains current and effective? What specific resources or organisations do you intend to use to ensure that your integration of AI into your practice aligns with your profession's codes of ethics? Can you describe how you will navigate the constantly evolving landscape of technology to ensure that your use of AI enhances rather than detracts from your work processes? AI technology is here to stay, and as social work, health, and social care professionals, we must influence how it's used. In this video, we've explored five important lessons about consent, privacy and confidentiality, flawed AI-based assessments and interventions, algorithmic biases, and using evidence-based AI tools ethically. I've also posed several questions whose answers I hope you're willing to share in the comments box below so that we can learn more from each other. My hope is that the lessons outlined and the questions posed provide a good starting point for discussion, debate, and beginning the process of critically thinking about how you can ethically introduce AI use into your own practices. I would encourage you to read the links I've provided below to explore the issues raised in this video further. I would really love to hear from you, so please do leave comments below, and do let me know if there are any other topics you'd like me to cover in my future videos. If you found the information in this video helpful, please do make sure that you like the video and consider subscribing to my channel. I've also put a link here to other AI-related videos that you may find useful. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye.